Hey, church family. Whenever two nations who've been at war finally stop their fighting, they usually sign something called a peace treaty. A peace treaty has terms and conditions that spell out how these two nations will continue to relate with one another in the days to come. Colossians 1 describes a peace treaty of sorts. That is, it presents us with the terms and conditions that are necessary in order for us to experience peace with God. How was this peace treaty achieved? Well, in Colossians 1, Paul wrote, "For God, in all His fullness, was pleased to live in Christ, and through Him, God reconciled everything to Himself. He made peace with everything in heaven and on earth by means of Christ's blood on the cross. This includes you, who were once far away from God. You were His enemies separated from Him by your evil thoughts and actions. Yet now He's reconciled you to Himself through the death of Christ in His physical body. As a result, He's brought you into His presence, and you're holy and blameless as you stand before Him without a single fault." What those verses tell us is that if you're a believer, you've been reconciled to the Father, restored to a right relationship with Him through the blood of Christ on the cross. It's Jesus' blood that brings you peace. No blood, no peace. Take away the blood and you don't have the gospel at all. We would often just as soon not think about the blood because the blood of Jesus reminds us of some very unpleasant truths. The truth that we're sinners who can't save ourselves. The truth that it's our sin that Jesus bore on the cross. It's our debt that He died to pay. We're going to come together to the Lord's table this weekend. And when we do, we'll be reminded that the sacrifice that Jesus made was one that He made willingly and gladly. Jesus told us, "No one can take my life from me. I sacrifice it voluntarily, for I have the authority to lay it down when I want to, and also to take it up again." The writer of the letter to the Hebrews says that we're to fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before Him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Because of what Jesus did on the cross, God sees you very differently than you are. Again, going back to those verses from Colossians that we began with, He calls us holy and blameless as you stand before Him without a single fault. Now, are we in fact actually unholy and blameless? No, not yet. But He sees us that way in Christ because He's justified us. He's declared us righteous if we've trusted in what Jesus did for us at the cross. One day we will actually stand perfected in God's presence in a new glorified body. In the meantime, He calls us to do our best to live like that here and now. He's calling us to peace with Him. He wants us to know that the war is over. It's time to surrender to His terms and conditions. And I pray that that is exactly what each of us would do. Amen.